that. All right, okay. So let us see on parallel operation of what? Of transformers, eh? All right, okay. So the first thing that you must know about the parallel operation of what? Of transformer is the condition that must be followed whenever you're connecting your transformer in what? In a parallel. Eh? So remember, a transformer can either be connected one in series or what? Or a parallel. So you must know the condition, and definitely I didn't write them on the board, I just write page. You'll get them on page 58. And then you must also know the method to reduce leakage flattening in a transformer. You must also know those methods. Basically, I just need this calculation, right? Alright, okay. And then you know the calculation, the formulas, they are not given on the formula sheet, so you must know. So alright, okay. So on A, the first formula that you have is to calculate what? The first apparent power. So they will say calculate each of the apparent power, which is S1 and what? And S2, ne? And remember, I said apparent power is measured in what? In KVA, ne? Yes. Alright, okay. So if they want you to calculate the first apparent power, which is S1, it's gonna be ST, which is the total apparent power, ne? At a given angle, multiplied by Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2, which is the first impedance, and then second impedance, ne? And then remember what they say about the angle. I said on your angle, if it is leading, and then it's positive, and then when it is lagging, it's what? It's negative, ne? All right, okay. And then you also have to calculate your S2. And please know there's a difference. On S1, it's ST at the given angle, ne? Multiplied by Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2, ne? And then on, if you're calculating the second apparent power now, it's gonna be ST at a given angle. Now you start with what? With Z1, eh? So it's gonna be Z1 divided by Z1 plus Z2, and you know how to get your power factor. It's what? It's cos theta, eh? All right, okay. So let's say they want you to calculate the normal power, which is measured in watts. It's just gonna be P1 is supposed to V multiplied by I multiplied by cos theta, and then if it is the total power, remember sometimes, let's say on this formula they gave you, let's say 30 watts, isn't it? And you know on your formula you have to use the apparent power, isn't it? So if sometimes they can give you a power which is the true power, which is this, so you have to use this formula, isn't it? Which says PT is equal to ST divided by cos theta, which means you have to get divided by cos theta to get your ST, because whenever you're doing your calculation, you must use the apparent power, not the true power, eh? All right, okay. And then please also note here, when you're calculating your Z, and don't be confused with this thing. So that I write Z A and Z B, the same thing as Z one or Z two. Sometimes they can use Z1 and Z2, or sometimes they use Z A or Z B, ne? So okay, when you're calculating your Z A, you are going to divide your apparent power, which is S1 divided by S2. But that's not always the case. You remember the one we were doing the other example. It's gonna be the big apparent power divided by the smaller one, ne? So when you just check which one is bigger, and then you divide, and then your R is the resistance, and then your X is what? The reactance, ne? So even here you have to use J notation. And then only when you are on ZB, you just have to get your R and what? And then your X, you don't have to divide anything, eh? So you only divide on Z, or ZA, or Z, or Z1 only. And then when you go to ZB, you just do it. There's no one, eh? All right, okay. So let us look on that example, which is August 2018. Okay, it reads as follows. They're saying the single phase transformer of equal voltage ratios with the following readings and impedance are connected in parallel to a supply of a load of what? I'm given the supply load. Okay, let me just write the given information here. I'm given the supply load of what, guys? It's PT, ne? Yeah. Of 11,000 kilowatts, ne? Okay, I'm also given the power factor, which is PF of 0.885, and it's lagging. All right, okay. And then they gave me a table, which is the transformer A, and then it also has the transformer on transformer B, ne? And then on the transformer A, I'm given S1, which is 1,400, ne? Mm-hmm. And then I'm also given, okay, let me just write it. I'm given S1 1400 kVA, and then I'm given R1, which is 2 ohms, and then I'm given X1, which is 8 ohms. I'm given S2, which is 2000 kVA. I'm given R2, 1.4, and then I'm also given X2, which is 7 ohms. Right? That's fine, let us see. So your question is saying, so these are the given information. Eh? So we are given the values of the first transformer and also the second transformer. Okay, and your question is saying calculate the KVA of each transformer as well as what? Is the power factor. Eh? So they want you to calculate S1, they also want you to calculate S2 and also the power factor. Eh? Alright, okay. And I said what's the formula to calculate S1? I said if you want to calculate S1, it's gonna be ST at a certain given angle multiplied by Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2. Ne? Okay, let us check. Do I have ST? No, I don't have ST. Ne? But I'm given what? I'm given the true power. Ne? So it means I can use which formula? I can use this formula to calculate my ST. Ne? Okay, so to get my ST, it's going to be the power which is given of what? 11,000 divided by cos theta, which is 0.0885.
So
12941. So I think I made a 1100 Yeah. So 1100.
So 1294.
1294, ne? Kilo. Or you have a comma. Comma?
118.
ABA, ne? Alright, okay, which means I have my ST, and then what did I say about Z1? As I said, to get your Z1 is going to be S1, S2, open brackets, R plus J, X. Ne? Okay, let us look. Which one is bigger between our S1 and S2? S2 is bigger. Ne? And remember, I said, whenever you're putting here, you must start with the bigger one, which means it's going to be 2,000 divided by 1,400. Okay.
2,000 divided by
1,400. Okay, and then my R is 2 plus, and then my X is what? It's 8. Can you divide this thing for me, please?
Which one?
2,000 divided by 1,400.
1,429.
Okay, open brackets, 2 plus J. J 8, and then you have to multiply this one with 2, and then multiply it with 8.
Eight plus J.
You multiply this one by this one.
11.432.
11.432. 432. Alright, okay. And then now I have to get my Z two, ne? And then I said on Z two, you don't have to multiply by S one over S two. Just gonna take it as it is, ne? Okay. And then my S two just gonna go on R two, which is 1.4 plus J7. Alright, okay.
So we have to leave our answers in red. The final answer.
The final answer must be in polar form, eh?
No, I'm talking about Z1. Why did we leave it in?
Well, why did we leave it like this?
Yeah.
Alright, okay. Since we still have the reg on this one. So we can leave it or you can even convert it, it's just the same.
Yeah.
Alright, okay.
What
are you getting here? Yeah? Was your multiply 1.429 multiplied by 8?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Was I said, yeah, this is the bracket, you multiply this one by that one. Alright, okay. So let us see. So can you add this one for me? To make it simple, Z1. Let me just say Z1 plus Z2. Eh? It's 2,858 plus J 11,432 plus 1,4 plus J 7. Can you please add these two for me? So it's gonna be 2,858 plus 1,4 4,258 Okay, plus 11,432 plus 7 18,432 Okay, Jay, can you please change it to bin point? You have to change your answer because it's in the reg. You have to change it to bin point. Okay, Jay, at the end of 76,999 Yeah? You know, I'm sorry, you're getting the same thing. Alright, okay. So it means I have this one, I have this part. Yeah? Alright, okay. Let us see. So to get my S1, it's gonna be, what is my ST? We said it's what? 1,294,118 At the angle of, remember you are given the power factor, can you cos inverse of this, because I need an angle, eh? Cos inverse of what? Of your power factor, you get your angle.
That's 1,79
Is what? 31,
79.
Alright, okay. Multiply by Z2. And then remember, it must be in polar form, eh? Because when I need division, can you please change your Z2 to be in polar form?
Seven comma one three nine.
Okay, and then again.
78,69
All right, okay, and then divide by, it's what, 18,917 okay, at the angle of 17. Okay, it's fine. So please, you have to multiply this one by that one, and then the angles, you're going to add them.
At 82.
And please not, it's lagging here, you're supposed to be having a negative, right? Because your angle, it's lagging, so it must be a negative. So it's going to be 1,294,118 multiplied by that side. What do you get if you multiply this one by this one level? This one multiplied by?
9,238
Sorry?
9,238
And then the angle, as I said, you're going to 8. So it's negative 31,97 79 plus 78,99 78,69
46,9
Okay, divide by this, ne? It is 18,917 And then this one you divide, and then the angles you subtract.
Comma
381. Okay, angle please.
-30.09.
0, 0, 9, eh? And then remember as well in K, KVN. Eh? So which means I have my S1. Eh? And then please note, they said the question said they want to calculate what the KVA of each and also the power factor. Eh? So to get my power factor, PF is going to be cos theta, eh? Which is the cos of what? Of 30.09. Since it is negative, it's going to be lagging. Eh?
Five.
Lagging. So you have your S1. So that's how you calculate your S1. Okay, so now when you're going to S2, which formula are you going to use that? So now you're just gonna do the opposite. Instead of starting with Z2, now you start with what? With Z1. Okay. So let us see, we said S2 is gonna be ST at the given angle multiplied by Z1 over Z1 plus Z2. Is it gonna be enough on my board? Okay, it's fine. What was our ST? It was 1.